Why is your fighter going to win this fight?
Which is a better fighter? Come man, on. This kid's good. This kid, listen.
Press
this, the you guys know. You
come
guys
on.
Know. But
come on. Two to two, Dave. Listen, come on. Tell us.
But listen, so this kid's not even been out of his gears yet, right? He's not even out of his comfort zone yet. And he's won the British and Commonwealth title in 13 fights, right? Mm,
that means
so. He's not even broke up a sweat yet. I honestly, little things that we're doing in the gym, he's getting straight away. He's understanding, right? Little things that I'm teaching him, he's understanding straight away, and he feels the benefits. He understands what I want to do him. He understands what I want to add to him. I'm not taking away shit from him because he's a quality fighter.
What's going on, Dave? Bro, every time I see you, your head is getting shinier and shinier. That means
man, I'm trying to keep it real.
That's money.
That's the money shine.
That's money shine.
You can't trick, man. Man's from the ends. We know about that bull shiny head. That means you got money. But how you doing, my man? So
I'm good, man.
You know,
really
it don't matter
good.
What time it is of the day, night. I'm Mr. Energy. So wake
that's
up,
cool,
splash the water on your face.
Drink some coffee.
Let's get cracking.
Mate, don't worry about that. I've only just put the kids to bed. They're going away for a week with the granddad tomorrow.
Where are they going to?
They're going to Cornwall tomorrow with the granddad. So they're going for a week. So it's going to be the first time I've been away from them for a week, but God knows how long.
You're going to cry, you know?
No doubt.
Hey, what did we tell you? Dave Coldwell's daughter.
Yes.
Yeah. Is a fantastic, she's going to be a big boy music producer. Remember, I'm telling you, and I'm going to give her a bus. And she's incredible. She makes some wicked tracks. Mm-hmm. She's, what, how is she now, 14?
She's good, man. She's 15. She's 16 in September.
No. I'm not joking. Seriously. And as for his son, Theo, my goodness, great. That boy is some... Do you remember Josima from Brazil?
Yeah, come on.
I want to say, come on. Right, no. That kid's got skills, you know?
Yes, sir. I see the post. See the post.
No, think about the post. You can play football. He's going to blow.
Do you know what it is, though? You'd love his attitude. He's a proper worker. His attitude, he don't care if something's hard and it's hard for him to do anything like that. He just wants to do it. Do you know what I mean?
What I will say is, children don't do what you tell them, they do what they see you do.
Yeah.
And that ethic has come from yourself, Dave. Because I remember going back, Joe Catchpole, we was up in, where was he? Sheffield.
It was Dave's show.
Yeah, Dave's show. And I remember he was running around the place. I'm like, bro, what's about this brother? He was up, down, everywhere.
He was on steroids, coffee, Lucozade, Red Bull.
Dave was working hard from them times.
Dave Coldwell was everywhere, even when we were standing still for that show.
So obviously, like father, like son, Dave. Don't worry about that. We know how this thing goes.
Right. We're going to keep this one really quick because you have an up and coming fight. You are now the new trainer of British and Commonwealth champion Lerrone Richards.
Excellent.
How did that come about, Dave?
Do you know what? It came on to me about it probably about a month, maybe 2 months ago, a month ago. Just had a chat with Sam Jones, his manager. Would it be interested in training Lerrone? At that time, I wasn't sure because I'm very selective about who I'm going to spend my time with, because whoever I'm spending my time with means time that I'm spent away from my family and my kids, stuff that I do. Do you know what I mean? And also, wear and tear on your body. Do you know what I mean? When you're working day in, day out, it's just wear and tear and the emotional energy that you're spending on fights. Because I'm not one of these fighters one of these coaches where it's just business. I'm emotionally invested.
Yes, sir.
So you've got to click with me. And I wasn't sure because I didn't know anything about Lerrone, to be honest. I didn't know what his first time
I don't
was
think
like,
nobody
really.
Does.
Yeah.
No,
he's very,
I know
he's
that's
very
what
reserved
mean.
Human
yeah,
being.
Very
very,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But you know what? So I left it and then he went over to Vegas, did some training with Ismael Salah. They came back and then he messaged me a couple of times just on bits. Just, you know, we were just in touch on Instagram. Nothing about training, nothing like that. And then Sam rang me up. He said, listen, he says, would you be interested? He said, well, you know, he really wants to train with you, blah, blah. would you give him a go? So I said, listen, let's have a go. Let's see how it works out.
Yes.
I asked him what he was like as a kid, and he said, listen, he's a really nice kid. You'll get on with me well. He's come day one in the gym, and you know he reminds me of when he came to me? He's Jordan Gill. Very, very similar mentality where it's just so easy to get on with. He's on my wavelength. No drama, no stress. Got that inner confidence. And mate, he is talented. Yeah. He is very talented.
Always been for me as a little kid. He won everything as a little kid. You know,
I can see that.
Yeah, I remember Lerrone, and I know his dad, and you know, known Lerrone for, he had a little off period, but he's somebody that has always had tremendous talent. And you know, if you can get him right, you know, I know World Champions is a tag that's thrown around a lot too much nowadays, but he literally does have that ability. If you get him right, and I'm sure you can definitely do it, because you've got that experience, and you know what it takes.
Yeah, I'm excited to work with him, because from day one, like I said, we just gelled straight away. Like literally, you know, like sometimes you're not sure about working with fire, just gelled with him straight away. Same as when I worked with Jordan, same as when I worked with Hope and Fire straight away. Yes. We just gelled, and he's on that same wavelength, same frequency in the gym. Slot straight in, he's got on with the lads. He's, you know, when I've brought my son down, he's got on with my son straight away. He's just that nice sort of kid. But do you know what I like about him? When he's in the ring, he's got a bit of aura about him, you know.
yeah.
You know when you watch him, we've had different people in spar with him today.
Yes.
And when you watch him spar, he's just got that aura about him where he's got levels, he's got gears. He's not shown his gears in fights yet, and I want to put gears into him.
Yes.
Because I think he's kind of been in that mode where he's happy just to win and just to do enough and be comfortable.
Yes.
But he's not gone out there and shown what he's capable of. And you know, when he's hurt people even, he's kind of like just
gone back to just,
gone back to fiddle about and stuff like that. Yes. There's a time and a place for that, and there's a time to be a little bit more ruthless and a little bit more
stamping authority.
Yes, that's a very interesting assessment. Can I ask you something? What's the situation that, like, the living arrangements? Is he staying in Sheffield?
Yeah. So he's living up here Monday. Same as the rest of the guys, really. Lives up here Monday to Friday. Goes on weekend.
Okay. Well, that's a working business relationship. Yeah. That's fantastic.
Yeah, I got to give him props for giving up the London lifestyle, and he's a proper. Was he a Wimbledon football fan?
Yeah, he is, yeah.
So
someone's got to do it.
But you know what? It's mad, because like Andrew Harding of Your Golf Travel, they sponsor Wimbledon. So yeah, I mean, send Andrew on Insta, send him a message, right, and tell him you want some money. I'll take it 25%. It's my full cup.
didn't Lerrone do like a pitch walkout?
Yeah, pitch walkout. I seen him do the pitch walkout the other day. No, but not only that, but he's got this fight potentially with Umar Sadiq for defending his two titles. And I wanted to ask you, because we had just had Umar running. Umar said there's categorically, there is no way in hell.
He said he's going to brock him up.
Right, so there's no way in hell.
Easier said than done.
Yeah.
The thing about it is this, I know you're not, Dave, I've known you 30 years now, right? So Dave's not a person to go back and forth.
Yeah.
Right. But what I do want to know is like, why is your fighter going to win this fight?
Because he's a better fighter. Man, this kid's good. This kid, listen. You guys know.
why are you trying to bring me in for, man?
Come on, don't try to bring us in.
They're cool. Black Lives Matter, man. What's the matter with you?
Come on. Talk the talk, Dave. Listen, come on. Tell us.
So this kid's not even been out of his gears yet, right? He's not even out of his comfort zone yet. And he's won the British and Commonwealth title in 13 fights, right?
That means
he's not even broke up a sweat yet. I honestly, little things that we're doing in the gym, he's getting straight away. He's understanding, right? Little things that I'm teaching him, he's understanding straight away, and he feels the benefits. He understands what I want to do him. He understands what I want to add to him. I'm not taking away shit from him, because he's a quality fighter. But just little things, like I said, gears, little things with his feet and ring savvy and ring generalship, just to be in a more of a punishing sort of manner, not yes. just being slick and looking good yes. and being comfortable. I want to put him in spots in sparring where he's not comfortable and where he's having to come out of his little zone and his comfort zone, you know?
Yes, yes.
And when all that sort of stuff adds together, then you're going to see something special because this kid is good. And yes. I've seen a lot of fighters in the gym and I've watched, you know, I've trained a lot of good fighters. But I look at him and, like I said, there's an aura about him.
Yeah, there is an aura about him. We've all known this since Duro was a kid. It's like we're just waiting. Right. We're just waiting for somebody get to yeah. get him yeah. to bring it out of him. We all yeah. know so, this about Lerrone.
So you know what? This is how I would describe. I actually went out because, like, I was talking to Jordan about him. Because Jordan didn't see his first sparring session with me. And when he sparred, I was just talking to Jordan about it. And you know what it reminds me of? Because he has this aura about him. It's everything's comfortable, and he's making people miss effortlessly. He's landing shots effortlessly. And then I got him to go up through a couple of little gears. But he's one of these guys where, and don't get me wrong, please don't take this the wrong way. I'm not saying he's on that level.
Yes.
But all I'm saying is when you watch a fighter and you have that sort of image of him and you look at him in this certain way, you know when you talk about Rigondeaux?
Yes.
Right? You can either watch him and he can either be, you watch him, you're thinking, fucking hell, you can do so much more. Do it.
Absolutely.
But it turns out it keeps in that comfort zone, and it turns out to be a boring fight. And yeah, you think, oh,
that's a great analogy. Yeah. That's
but
great.
It's been a masterclass.
You left a little, yeah, it's a masterclass, but yeah, you're left a little bit yeah. underwhelmed, right?
Yes.
But when he has that mode where he goes through his gears and does his shit, and you look and you go, wow, fucking hell, he's good.
Yes.
This is how I looked at Lerrone. First sparring session, that's how I looked at Lerrone. Again, like I said, please don't say I'm saying he's like but I'm saying that's the same sort of way that I looked at him, and I thought, wow, this kid is when I've seen his fights before, that's how I've seen him. I thought, oh yeah, he's very good, but he's just comfortable and he's just happy just to yes. do what he's doing, and he's not interested in going through the gears or anything. But when he does go through those gears, the kid's very, very good.
Yes.
And that's what I want to instill into him, where he's going to be a little bit more punishing, have a little bit more devil about him. Like he does have that. I love that. It's not in a bad way, but he has that arrogance when he's in the ring.
Yeah.
He has that arrogance, you know, definitely. But in a good way, not where he thinks he's too good, and he's not, you know what I mean? But he has that arrogance where he believes in himself.
It's all
and
belief.
I tell you what, he ticks so many boxes. So yes. I'm excited to work with him, really.
Yes, I know that I know the dad very well. We're all friends, and I remember his dad used to say to me, son, Tun, I'm telling you, my son's an old school fighter. He's a throwback. You know, his dad's been saying this to me for years, and it's gonna be a great fight because I feel that Umar can bring that little thing that we're all waiting to see with Lerrone out.
Yeah.
Because you know, Umar's got an engine. And he's going to, you know, I call him the black Manny Pacquiao. Yeah. So that, well, we saw what Floyd done to Manny Pacquiao. So, it could be one of them cases. But the thing is that Lerrone is always going to be the fighter that, because he's so skilled, it's like, it's going to take that fighter to show the next level. And I guess if you can see that with him in the gym, you'll be comfortable going into the fight knowing that that's in the locker if he needs to do that. So it's a great time, and I'm happy Lerrone's got a good guy in his corner,
100%.
A guy with experience, you know, a guy with a lot of experience,
and one of the most genuine people in boxing.
Absolutely.
Dave Coldwell.
Energy don't lie.
It's true. He's proper genuine, and he's very, very supportive. So I always give like Dave Coldwell a massive big up. Really good guy.
Big up.
Keep on doing what you're doing, Dave.
Keep shining, baby.
Right, keep shining. And what round? And what round do I expect? So, yeah, I mean, I don't bet, but I know a lot of people out here can be betting.
Oh, no. Listen, but I respect.
I want to hear it. Tell me the thing, my friend.
No, I respect him enough. I think it's going to be a really good fight. It's going to be a very clever fight.
Yes.
But I think, like you said to me, I think this is a guy that's going to bring out another level to Lerrone, and you're going to see something that you're going to be entertained by, and you're going to be impressed by.
Well, regardless of the social distance, I'm coming to that fight there. I don't business. I'm going to tell Frank, just get an extra seat in there or something. I need to see this fight. This fight is going to be a good one. But thank you for your time, okay. Dave.
No problem.
Really appreciate it. The one, the only, the new trainer of Lerrone, Sniper Boss Richards, Dave Coldwell.
Big up, Dave. Thank you very much, brother. Cheers, man.
Remember to like, comment and subscribe to the Stamina for Soul YouTube channel.